What is up, everybody? Here with another unboxing video. As you can tell from the title, it's the Jordan 11 Low in the cool gray colorway. I know I've been saying that I needed to do another unboxing of something else other than a soccer shoe. So that's what I'm doing. I know I took a little while on this to upload this. I've had these for a few days. But better late than never, right? So let's get into it. Got the unboxing going on. Look at this knife. By the way, I got this from the Dollar Tree for a dollar. Like I said, some things we can do on a budget. That's what I'm all about, I guess, sometimes. Saving some money. You gotta save somewhere. Maybe not always in shoes, but you gotta save somewhere. So open up the box right away, of course. Comes the standard, always Nike receipt, the shipping label to send back. Hopefully my address doesn't come out on that. And then inside you got the regular black with the gold, black box with the gold Jumpman, and then these dumb things, which I don't know what that's for really. And then we'll throw that out with all the other boxes that are over there. Again, one more time, open up, you got your classic white paper with the 23 logo on them, and open up, first look at them, we'll cut that out, just kidding, and there you go, there you have it, there's a shoe. Let's take it out of the box. This is not the first time I'm seeing these in person. I was actually in Chicago Saturday when they came out, and I was thinking about buying them at Nike Town. See, but the only thing with that is if I would have bought them at Nike Town, I would have had to pay retail for them, which retail is $175. And I woke up late, tired. And so I decided just to wait them out on the app, on the Swoosh app, as you can tell. Yeah, I'm representing that, Swoosh. New staff dress, which might go, not so much. But yeah, so the Swoosh app, if you don't know what that is, that's just our employee discount app where we get our employee prices with our discounted prices, I mean. So right away, first look at the shoe. A lot of people don't like the lows, but these sold out, so I was able to get them. That's the thing. See, usually at Nike Towns, you can't buy a shoe, or if it gets returned to a store, us employees can't purchase a shoe unless it's been, I think, 2 days from when we get it. So these came out Saturday. You can't buy these at Nike Town till Monday, so they have to sit unless you're willing to pay retail. And there's no way around that. Like, you can't buy the shoe at full price. People probably say, buy the shoe at full price, and then you just return it and then buy it again. Well, that's against policy, so you definitely can't do that. So you just have to either wait on the app and see if they don't sell out, or just pay retail for it. And honestly, I would have paid retail for these had I seen that they were selling out pretty quick. But they eventually did sell out, so I don't know if that was just due to employees who purchased them or people bought them. A lot of people do not like the lows. I like the lows, actually. And then if you've done your research, MJ himself actually played in some low 11s against Seattle Supersonics in the bread 11s. So I mean, this is not the same. I wouldn't say it's the same as the mid, because it's obviously different. It only comes with one lace. You got the patent leather around there. And then you got like the translucent sole on the bottom. I don't have a problem with that. A lot of people try to claim that stuff is too icy, but most of the people complain are gonna buy the shoe anyway. So that's what I don't understand. Like, that's a whole different issue that I want to make a video on, about people complaining about Jordans, and like, you're still buying them. Like, stop complaining about them. Or just don't buy them, and then maybe, I don't know, maybe they'll change something. A lot of people complain about quality, which, that, like I said, that's a whole other video that I'm going to make, that I plan on making. Just my thoughts on stuff. And then of course on the inside, got the Jumpman logo right there, and the size, I'm 10.5. You got the 23, and then the Jumpman logo, which I like that little detail. Maybe because the mids definitely do not have that. So I kind of like that it has the 23 and the Jumpman logo right there. Maybe people just want the number, but I kind of like that. And then inside, you got a little bit darker gray with the in the inside. So and then my the one bad thing about 11s that I've noticed since they first came out is I don't know if the camera will pick that up, but you can kind of see there's like little imperfections on the white thing. But that's been with all the Jordans, I would say, throughout the years. This is not like anything new or something that is recent. This has always been it's not smooth. Like, you can kind of see. I wish the camera really would pick it up, but it's not going to. And then of course on the bottom you get your carbon fiber. It's real, I think. I don't think it's, I got a fake pair. I've seen fake pairs of 11s and it's bad. This is basically just, they just paint this on, and it's really funny. They really just paint this on, and it's not carbon fiber at all. This is carbon fiber, nice and hard. And then of course you have your two different gray colorways right there. I definitely wanted these because I don't have the mids, and sometimes when you don't have something, you gotta settle for the next best thing. And for me, these are the next best thing. I've been wanting a gray shoe as well. I don't really have a gray shoe, so for me, it was a no-brainer to buy. And like I said, I was willing to pay the full price for it, but thankfully I didn't have to. And then one thing I would have changed, if this would have been a leather, I would have liked that, because that's the one thing I like about the 11 lows, is the when they're leather up here. Closing ceremonies, I guess, with the white and the gold. I got two pairs of those, and I love that it's just leather. You know, that to me just makes a shoe. That's why I don't understand why shoes sometimes are the same price, because you get different materials and different shoes. So I feel the price should be adjusted to the materials that you're getting. So if this is a nice suede though, or new buck, whatever you want to call it, but like some of like the cherry lows, that's just I don't even know what that's called. So to me, in my opinion, I think they should be priced according to the materials that you get. And now, well, hold on. That's I'll show you that part too. You got the classic logo that always came with the Jordan 11s, and my ultimate test for shoes in general, but the 11s is a smell test. So let's smell them. Definitely smell like what 11s used to smell like back then when they first started making them. I don't know if it was my Space Jams or what other 11s that I had. But they don't smell like Jordans anymore. Jordans just don't smell like Jordans anymore. And as awkward and weird as that may sound, like, that was one of the things that I love the most, when you just open a box up and you can smell the shoe right away. And nowadays, that doesn't happen. But, I mean, for the most part, they smell pretty good. They smell like Jordans. Definitely get my approval on that. These are the 11s. Let me know if you copped the pair. If you didn't, what you would change, why you don't like 11s, why you do like 11s. Like I said, this is a great colorway. It's perfect for summer. It'll go with anything. And honestly, to the people that say they get dirty, I do is clean mine with the Clorox, my 11s, the bottom. I just clean with the Clorox wipe. And yes, it's a hassle and it's a pain to do, but if you really care about your shoes not yellowing, for some reason that has worked with me. Now, I don't wear my 11s a lot, but my Space Jams that I do have, all I do is give a quick wipe and it seems to work, and then I just put them back away in the box. It's a hassle and it sucks to have to do, but I mean, that's when you invest money in something, you want to protect it. So I don't feel I don't feel like that's a major step or something crazy to have to do, you know? So that's my advice. That's how I clean all my shoes as well. All I use is Clorox wipes. I clean my soccer shoes with that. I clean my basketball shoes. There's no bleach in the towels, so they're safe and okay to go to use. And yeah, I mean, that's my recommendations as far as cleaning shoes. I could do a video on that as well, just to prove that I do that, and I don't know what other people do. I know people say the magic eraser, but for me, the Clorox wipes just work, you know, okay. You take the Clorox thing, tip it upside down, and give it a shake, because most of the liquid, the cleaning stuff, is at the bottom. So you want to be able to soak the towels that come with it in the solution, and it makes them nice and wet. And then that's another thing. If you ever run out of the wipes, you should still have the liquid inside that you can just put regular towels and shake them up, and then just pull it out, and you can rinse it back, and then you can still use it as clean. So I mean, they kind of last for a long time if you do it that way. But enough of this review. Hopefully you liked it, and hopefully you keep watching my videos. Give me a like if you liked it, and let me know if you picked up your 11s, if you were able to get some. If not, I'm sorry. It's a nice shoe, whether it's a low or not. It definitely doesn't look like a women's shoe for those people who say that 11 lows are for women. It's definitely a cool shoe. So stay tuned for more videos, and we'll see you at the next one. Peace.